Hello students, I am N.K. Thukral from Edupedia World. Students, in the previous sessions, I had given you tips on short answer type questions and long answer type questions. Today, I am going to give you some tips on application-based questions. Application-based questions means where justifications are required against the questions or explanation is required. So before coming to the point, I advise all the students that each and every student must go through the study material very carefully. Better would be if you go through the textbook coming under NCERT standard. So what points you need to remember, students? I may tell you that read the question thoroughly. Number one point. What I mean? Read the questions thoroughly. I always advise the students to read the questions very thoroughly. Only then you will be able to know as what exactly is required from you. If justification is required, give the same with suitable example. And if explanation is required, give the same appropriately. Now students, next point is understand the question and if required twice. So I mean to say, never be in a hurry. Always read the question twice and understand the question. Once the things are clear to you in your mind, you will be able to quickly answer the questions. So it is also as important as number one. Another is jot down the points to answer. Students, make it a point to jot down the points before answering the questions. I advise to all the students that make it a habit to write points before you proceed to answer the questions. Another point is to give the answer a no or yes if asked like that. If answer is required in the form of either yes or no, then give the answer accordingly. Do not try to explain the yes or no if not asked specifically. Next point is not to answer in descriptive manner if not asked. I mean, where the question is of short answer type, then ensure that you are answering in brief and not unnecessary lengthy the answer. You are not going to get or you are not going to score the marks for giving explanation unnecessarily. Now students, next point to remember is try to underline the words which needs importance. I mean to say here that always try to underline the points of importance in the answer. Try to give point wise answer, giving the heading and then underline the same. You will get good marks in this fashion if you are writing the answer. Another is try to be brief. I mean to say, as I explained in point number 5 above, that always be to the point and brief your answer in such type of questions. Next is always try to conclude if question is quotation based. So students, I would like to advise you that always make it a point that in the questions where it is written justify or comment, there you need to see first of all that proper explanation is given and thereafter, you must conclude your answer. Always conclude your justification in a brief and appropriate manner. And last point to remember is try to give illustration if the question demands. So students, these are the few tips I wanted to give you as you must remember before answering the questions under application-based type of questions. Now students, let me give you some illustrative type of questions and I will tell you how to answer these questions. Number one question you can see in the slide is that Mohit sells his PlayStation to his friend at a profit of Rs. 2000. Will it be considered as a business? Number one question. Second is asks, state the feature of a business which is being highlighted in this example. So students, what is asked from you? Number one, it is asked, under given the quotation, Mohit sells his PlayStation to his friend at a profit of Rs. 2000. Now, will it be considered as a business? Now, students, let me take back you on the chapter Nature and Purpose of Business. Under Nature and Purpose of Business, what are the characteristics of business? There are so many characteristics of business. One of the characteristics is dealing in goods and services on a regular basis. This is one of the characteristics of business. Means a single transaction of sale or purchase does not constitute business. Suppose If you want to sell a mobile at a profit, it does not constitute business. Similarly, similar type of question is asked here, that Mohit sells his PlayStation to his friend at a profit of ₹2,000. So it's a single transaction. It is not a transaction of a regular type of business. So what you have to answer? Simply you have to answer no. Further, state the features of a business which is being highlighted in this example. Now briefly, if you said no, just justify in a very brief manner and giving the answer of the second question. Now, what is the activity? The features highlighted in the given example is dealing in goods and services on a regular basis. Simply this, your answer is finishes. Means you have to first say no, and then you have to write it will not be considered as a business as it is a single transaction of sale. And what are the feature means? The feature are that dealing in goods and services on a regular basis of such type of businesses. Next question is, as you can see in the slide, is that Mr. Kamal Bansal is a chartered accountant. His wife is a manager in a bank, and his son Abhinay has a factory in Faridabad where he produces steel pipes, means where he is manufacturing. Name the economic activities in which Mr. Kamal, Mrs. Kamal and Abhinay are engaged. So what is asked in the question, that what type of business? Students, under chapter nature and purpose of business, if you know what is business and what is profession and what is employment, you can answer very accurately here. So how you have to answer? When you understand what is profession and what is business, you have to simply answer that no, it will not be considered as a business, as Mr. Kamal Bansal is a chartered accountant, so it's a profession. So what you have to answer? Mr. Kamal Bansal is engaged in a profession. Now come to the second point. His wife is a manager in a bank, means his wife is an employee of a bank. So what is that? In employment. So you have to answer, Mrs. Kamal is in employment. But third question is asked about the Abhinay. Abhinay has a factory in Faridabad where he produces steel pipe, means he is in manufacturing activity. So he is in business. What you have to write? Mr. Kamal Bansal is engaged in a profession. Mrs. Kamal, his wife, is in employment, and his son Abhinay in business. Simply you have to write this. Your answer is clear. Now students, let's go ahead. And next question is, illustrative question is on forms of business organization. So as you can see in the slide, the question is asked, Vikram is promoting a company. Before the company is formed, he enters into a contract with Unitech for purchase of land and also agrees to pay rupees 50 crore within a period of 3 months also. Then the company was formed within 2 months. On the basis of facts, answer the following. What are the answers? Answers are, which type of contract is entered by Vikram? Number one. Second question is the contract legally binding on the company? Third question is in this, can Unitech holds Vikram liable for payment of money? And next is asked, what can the company do to prevent Vikram from such a situation? Now students, I will take back you on the chapter of forms of business organization. The answer to this question lies there. So under forms of business organization, you must have read promotion of a company, means how the company is formed, what are the promoters, what are their functions, and how the certificate of incorporation is received, and how the company can commence the business, what are the effect of certificate of incorporation. If all these things in detail you have read, you can answer these questions very clearly. So let's see how you can answer. Number one, in the question A is asked, which type of contract is entered by Vikram? Simply, it is a type of preliminary contract. As in the question, it is given that before the company is formed, he enters into a contract with Unitech for purchase of land and also agrees to pay rupees 50 crore. So he has entered into contract before the company is formed. So what is this? This type of contract is called a preliminary contract. So what you have to answer here? The answer is, the type of contract entered into by Vikram is known as preliminary contract. Such contracts are entered into by promoters with third parties on behalf of the company before its incorporation. So this is the answer. Now second is asked, is the contract legally binding on the company? Simply you have to say no. The contract is not legally binding on the company and company cannot ratify the contract even after its incorporation, as company was not in existence at the time of contract. So this is the answer. Another question is asked in this, can Unitech hold Vikram liable for payment of money? You can say yes. The company can hold Vikram personally liable for payment of money. So personally liable. Next is asked, what can the company do to prevent Vikram from such a situation? The answer is, the company may enter into fresh contract with Vikram as the same terms and conditions in order to honor the contracts made by Vikram. So you can write very clearly that the company may enter into fresh contract with Unitech Limited on the same terms and conditions. You have to write on the same terms and conditions in order to honor the contracts. If the contracts needs to be honored, so it has to enter it's a fresh contract with the Unitech Limited. So this is the all these four are answered accordingly. So now students, let's go ahead. What is the next question? Next question from form of business organization is, as you can see in the slide, it is given that in a quotation form, that is, Merchant Limited was issued certificate of incorporation by the registrar on 7th of the March. However, the date mentioned on the certificate was 2nd March. The company entered into contract for purchase of land with ABC Limited on 5th March. Now, the ABC Limited is not interested to sell the land as it is getting much higher price from another buyer. Now, question is, can Merchant Limited file a case against ABC Limited? Now, students, in this question, I think twice if you read the question, you will get answers automatically. So what is there that in this question, it is given that certificate of incorporation was issued by registrar on 7th of March. However, by wrongly, I can say you that date mentioned on the certificate was 2nd of the March. So in the meantime, the company entered into contract for purchase of land on 5th of the March. So you go it again thoroughly that what is the date? Date here is 2nd March. The date was mentioned in certificate of incorporation and the contract with ABC was on 5th of the March. Now ABC Limited is not interested to sell the land and it is getting much higher price from another buyer. Now can Merchant Limited file a case against ABC Limited? It is yes, because the date was written on 2nd March and contract was on 5th March. So it is very well within his the ambit of having the contract. So what you have to write in the answer? Yes. Then you have to justify yes. But how you can justify that? That Merchant Limited can file a case against ABC Limited as company was in existence on 5th March. Although wrong date is entered in the certificate, still certificate of incorporation is a conclusive evidence of regularity of incorporation of a company, irrespective of any deficiency. If deficiency is there, that is not concerned, but is certificate of incorporation was given on the 2nd of March and within that period the contract was made. So the contract is valid and ABC Limited is under a legal obligation to honor the contract. So this is the answer. I think you are very clear now. Now the next question is, both public and private company can commence after obtaining certificate of incorporation. Do you agree? Now the students, here the question is on public and private company. If you remember that how the public company is incorporated and how they get the certificate of commencement of business, and similarly in case of private company, then you will be able to answer very clearly. So what are the features of public company? What are the features of private company? You must be knowing. If you know that, you can answer very quickly. Now the answer is here, no. What is asked? Both public and private company can commence business after obtaining certificate of incorporation. Means it. The question is of obtaining certificate of incorporation means business can be commenced or not, both by public and private. No, they are separate. So what you have to answer? No, I do not agree with the given statement. Clearly you have to write, I do not agree with the given statement. Further, you have to justify a private company can immediately commence its business after obtaining a certificate of incorporation. However, a public company has to undergo two more stages, that is capital subscription and commencement of business. So these are the two features of public company. So both cannot be for the same public and private company. So like this, you have to answer. Now students, let's go ahead. Next illustrative question is asked, as you can see in the slide, is on public and global enterprises. Now what is the question? Identify the form of public sector enterprises in the following cases. Simply, you have been asked to identify. A, minimum 51% of the paid up capital is held by the government. B, LIC and Air India are the examples of this form of enterprise. And C, these enterprises are set up under a special act of parliament. So these three things are given before you, and you have to identify the form of public sector enterprises. Students, you must be remembering, if you know the definitions, means very clearly what is private company, what is government company, what is public company, what are the global company, mean MNC, then you will be answered very quickly. So here, if you know the definitions, then you can answer A, minimum 51% of the paid up capital is held by the government. Means how you can answer here, simply you have to write is the form of public sector enterprise under category A is a government company, since minimum 51% of the paid up capital is held by the government. Second, LIC and Air India are the example of this form of business. What you have to write here, statutory corporation. Now why I am giving you answers, statutory corporation means, what is the definition? If you remember, the definition of statutory corporation is that statutory corporation is a corporate body with a separate legal existence, means separate legal existence, set up under a special act of parliament or of the state legislature. So this is the definition of statutory corporation. So statutory corporation of such type of public enterprises means LIC or Air India or RBI. So here the question is that LIC or Air India means it is a statutory corporation. C, what is asked? These enterprises are set up under a special act of parliament. Now, what is the answer? Answer is statutory corporation. Next question under this chapter, public and global enterprises, is before you. That is, you can see in the slide, why MNCs are in a position to exercise massive control on the world economy. So, what is asked from you? MNCs are in a position to exercise massive control on the world economy. Why? Now students, if you remember, under private, public and global enterprises, if you know what are the features of global enterprises or multinational companies, MNCs, you can answer very quickly and answer it with you. That means features, what features? I can give you just example, huge capital resources, foreign collaboration, advanced technology, product innovation, market strategy, etc., etc. So here, how you can answer? You can answer like this, that MNCs are characterized by possessing huge financial resources and the ability to raise funds from different sources. Because of their financial strength, they are able to survive under all circumstances. This is number one. Second is, you can give MNCs possesses technology superiorities and are able to conform to international standards and quality specifications. Another reason you can give, they use aggressive marketing strategies and their sales promotion techniques are very clearly effective because of their established brand image in the global markets. So these, if you give, these reasons you give, your answer is complete. Means MNCs are in a position to exercise massive control on the world economy because of the following reasons. Let's see in the next class, what are the other type of illustrative questions under application based question and how you have to answer. Let's call for the day. Thank you. Bye-bye.